I created a tool that lets you generate personalized PDF and Word documents directly from your Excel data. The idea is simple. You create a Word template with placeholders, and those placeholders will be replaced with text, images, Excel charts, or tables. So, if you want to create multiple contracts, invoices, business reports, or personalized letters, this tool can save you hours of work. And the best part, no coding is required, and it works on Windows and even macOS. Alright, so without further ado, let us jump in and see how it works.
So here I've got a regular Word document that I'm using as a template. Inside it I've added placeholders using double curly braces. Down in the signature area there's a shape that works as a placeholder for an image that I want to insert later. On the second page I've added another placeholder. That one will be replaced by an Excel table. And at the bottom of the page I also want to insert an Excel chart. Now the data that fills all these placeholders comes from my Excel sheet. So each row in that sheet holds the data I want to insert into my Word document. And to make sure that the data goes into the right spot, I just have to rename my column headers in Excel to match the placeholder names in my Word template. So for example, in my first document, I want to replace the client placeholder with Mr. Jason Peterson. That means in my Excel sheet, I've got a column named client. Next, I've got a vendor column. And in this first row, the vendor placeholder will be replaced with Hall PLC and so on and so forth. And if I scroll a bit to the right, you will also see that I've added the inputs for the signature image, the Excel table, and the chart placeholders. Now, the Excel table and also the chart I want to insert is already prepared in my datasheet. So, right here you can see the two different tables and also the charts that I will be using. And in just a moment I will show you how to set up everything from scratch. But for now, let me just place my Excel table and my Word document next to each other and press the export button. You will now see a progress bar popping up, and the tool is now going through each row and saving the new documents into my output folder, which is right over here. Also in my case I've set up in the settings so that I get not only the Word document, but also a PDF file. Now for this example I'm only creating 10 documents, but of course you can create hundreds or even thousands of documents all in one go. And once the export is done, let's pick one of the files to check the result. Alright, and as you can see here, the data has been replaced. And what's really nice here is that it also keeps any formatting you have applied in Excel. So if you have formatted a date in a certain way or added some multi-line text, it shows up exactly like that. And in the signature area, we can also see that the placeholder shape has been replaced with an actual image. And the same goes for the table and the chart. By the way, this table here is also not a static image. It is actually a real editable Word table that keeps all the styles from Excel. So that makes it much easier if someone needs to copy or work with the data later on, because they can now easily just copy the data from the table. Alright, and just below the table you will also find the chart, which is added as an image. Now there might be also the case that you want to send out this file, but you want to make sure that no one can change it. And for that, instead of saving it as a Word document, you can also export it as a PDF file, just like I did here. So if I open one of the PDF files, you will also see that the placeholders have been replaced. And also in this version, you can actually see that I used a different signature image and also different tables and charts. And that's where the automation really shines, because you can set up everything in Excel. So that means which image should go into which document. And with that flexibility, you can now create fully personalized documents at scale. And the best part is, you don't have to build anything new. You can just use your Word documents you already have. And those documents, you just need to add the placeholders for your text, or insert shapes that act as placeholders for the images, tables, or Excel ranges. Also, in just a minute, I will walk you through an example on how to build a template from scratch. But before we do that, let's take a quick look at the tool itself. Alright, so here in the first column, you can set the output name for each file. Now you can type that in manually, but in my case, I use a formula to combine the word contract with the vendor name. And that way, the output file gets created automatically. Next, for the actual values, you can either type in your text or numbers, or you can just regular Excel formulas. For example, right here I'm using the today formula and adding 7 days to get the date for the next week. Now what's really nice is that you can also apply custom formats and the tool will keep the formatting in the final document. So basically the idea here is that what you see in Excel is exactly what you will see in your exported file, just like in my example here. So here I used a custom format to show the day of the week followed by a comma, and that shows up exactly the same in my document. Okay, next we've got a text block. And as you saw earlier, you can also use line breaks here. Okay, next we've got some numbers, and again, you can format them however you want. For example, for the total amount, I used US currency formatting with no decimals. And right next to it, I used a formula to calculate the non-refundable amount, which is 20% of the total. And lastly, I've got today's date, and again, here I'm using the today formula. Now, all those are text placeholders. But as you have seen, you are not just limited to text. If you want, you can also replace shapes with images, Excel tables or Excel ranges. To do that, you just enter the image path, the name of the Excel table or the name of the named range you want to insert. The tool will then check in the background if it's a valid image path, table or range. And if that is the case, it will replace a placeholder shape with the right content. So that means for the signature placeholder, I've just added the image path directly into my cell here. And you can also see here that I've used different signatures for different documents. Now I kept it pretty simple here by entering the path directly, but of course you can also use an if formula to choose different images based on your logic. Now and if you want to insert Excel data, you just need to reference a table or the range you want to include. Now in my case I created a new sheet that looks like this. Here I've got two Excel tables. When I click on them, you will see I've given each table a name. And also I defined two named ranges that include my charts. One of them is called Tech Conference Chart. And when I select it, you can see the exact range it covers. Now everything in that range will be saved as an image, and then that image will replace my placeholders in my Word template. Alright, and now that you have got a first idea of what's possible, let me quickly show you how to start using the tool. Like I mentioned earlier, you can use any existing Word document. But in my case, I'm just going to create a new blank one and call it Example Template. By the way, the name doesn't matter. You can name it whatever you like. So in this new document, I will go ahead and add some text. To insert placeholder text, all you need to do is to wrap the name in double curly braces. In my case, I'm using two text placeholders, Amount and Result. Oh, and by the way, you can also use the same placeholder more than once. The tool will then find all the instances and replace them automatically. Alright, and right next to my text, I want to insert an image. To do that, I just draw a regular shape onto my page here. And the good thing is that you don't have to worry about the different dimensions of your images, because the tool will resize your image to fit the shape, but it will always keep the original aspect ratio. So that means your image won't be stretched or distorted. Alright, next I'm gonna add another shape that acts as a placeholder for my Excel table. Now here the final height of the table will be based on how tall your actual Excel table is. So that is why here I just need to focus on setting the right width for the placeholder shape. Okay, and lastly, let's also add a chart. Technically speaking, this will be actually an Excel range. And inside that range, I've got a chart that I want to insert into my Word document. Now I will show you what I mean by this in just a second. For now, let me also just paste the shape here. And just like with the image, the tool will automatically resize the chart to fit the placeholder shape, while keeping the initial aspect ratio. Alright, and now that we've added all the shapes, we need a way to tell the tool which shape should be replaced by which value from Excel. And for that, we will use bookmarks. So, just select the shape, go to the Insert tab, and click on Bookmark. Here you can enter the bookmark name, which should match a placeholder tag from Excel. So in my case, I will name this one My Image. But of course, you can name it however you want. Then I will repeat the same steps for the table and also for the chart. That means, just select the shape, click on Bookmark, enter a name, and you're done. Okay, and with that in place, we can also quickly validate our inputs by clicking on the bookmarks again. And here you will now see the bookmarks I have added. That also means, in total, we have now 5 placeholders. Amount, Result, My Chart, My Image, and My Table. And with all that set up, I will go ahead and save the Word document and switch back to Excel. Now to start fresh here, I will clear the existing table by clicking this button here. Alright, so now all we need to do is to match our column headers to the placeholder names we used in Word. And here it is really important that you type the name exactly as they appear in your Word file. So also the letter case matters here. Additionally, you also want to make sure that you don't include the curly braces. So that means for this example, I will enter Amount, Result, My Image, My Table and My Chart. Now that we've got the headers in place, we can start filling out the rows. So each row here will now generate one document. For this demo, I will just create two documents to keep it simple. And for the result column, I'm going to use a formula to calculate 20% of the amount. Next, I will format both numbers as USD and leave out the decimal places. Alright, now let's move on to the image. For that, we just need to paste in the file path of the image we want to use. So let me go ahead and open my folder where I have a couple of images. Next, I will right-click on the image and select Copy as Path. Then, back in Excel, I will press Ctrl and V to paste in the image path into my cell. Just make sure to remove the quotation marks at the beginning and the end of the file path. Now, and also just to be clear here, if you are just using the same image for every document, then of course it doesn't really make sense to use the placeholder, because in that case, you could have just inserted the image directly into your Word template. But just to show you that it can be a little bit more dynamic, here's another example. So here I'm using an if statement to pick a different image based on my data. So let's say if the result is less or equal than 30, then I want to use this image here. Otherwise, I will use this one. So now, depending on the values in your table, the tool will insert a different image into each document. But for me, I will just keep it simple and leave out the formula. Alright, and with that said, let's continue by filling out the last two placeholders, which is the table and our chart. Now, you might already have your tables or your chart in another workbook, and that is totally fine. You can just copy your existing sheet into this tool here. And once the data is in this spreadsheet, you can reference it directly. So that means to insert a table, just click on it and copy the table name to your clipboard. Then go back to the other tab and paste the name right into the cell here. And also let me do the same for the other table. So I will select it, copy the table name and paste it into this row. Okay, and for the last column, that's gonna be our chart. But here's the thing, we are not actually inserting the chart name itself. Instead, we will insert a named range that contains the chart. The tool will then take a snapshot of that range and insert it as an image into our document. Now, if you've never used named ranges before in Excel, let me quickly show you what I mean. So, to define a named range, just select the cells you want, then go to the name box at the top and type in the name, like my new range. Once you press enter, you have now created a new named range. And when you select it from the drop-down menu, you will see exactly which cells are included. And that's basically the same thing I have done with my charts. Each chart now here is included in my named range. So all I need to do here is now to insert that name into my Excel table. In this case, I've got my Tech Conference chart and also my Catering chart. Alright, now the last thing we need to do is to define our output file name. This can be, of course, again a formula, or in my case, I will just call it example 1 and example 2. Okay, and now we are almost done. We just need to set the path to our Word template and also the output folder. And we will do that in the settings sheet. Here you can either type in the paths manually or just use the button, which is a little bit easier. So first I will select the Word template we just created. Next I will choose the output folder. This can be any folder you already have, but in my case I will just create a new one and call it example output. Then I'm gonna select it and then click on OK. Alright, and lastly you can also choose the output file type. You can export your documents as Word files, PDFs or both. Alright, and with all that in place, we are now ready to export the data. And for that, just click on the export button. You will now see a progress bar and once it's done, you will get a confirmation message. Okay, and to check that everything worked, let's go to the output folder. Here you will now see both the Word and also the PDF files we just created. So let me open the PDF file first. Alright, and as you can see, the text values have been replaced correctly. And also the image, the Excel table and also the chart were also inserted as expected. Okay, and now let's also have a look at the Word document for the second file. Okay, and here again, everything was replaced exactly the way we wanted. Alright, and that's how easy it is to create personalized documents in Bike right from your Excel data. Now to wrap things up, let me also quickly explain the other buttons in the settings sheet. So what you have seen in this video is the first version of the tool. But depending on your feedback, I might add new features in the future. So if you want to check whether there's a new version available, just click on the Check for Updates button. Also, if you need support or you have ideas on how to improve the tool, you can use those buttons here to go straight to my contact form. Additionally, I've also created a dedicated documentation page. There you will find helpful guides and tutorials on how to use the tool. And also here you will find a Getting Started video that walks you through everything in even more detail, really step by step to get you up and running in no time. Okay, and lastly, you might have noticed there's also a field for a license key. And that's because the tool comes in both a free and a pro version. The free version has a few limitations, like how many documents you can export at once, the available output formats, and the type of the placeholders you can use. Now you can find all the details about that on my website. It will be the first link in the description. Now if you decide to use the free version, you can just leave in the license key field blank here. But if you upgrade or decide to get the pro version, you will receive your license key right after your purchase by email. And once you enter that key, you will unlock all the features. Now currently I'm offering this tool as a lifetime deal. That means you can buy the tool once and you can use it forever and create as many documents as you want. So if you would like to download the tool, as I said, just check out the first link in the description. Alright, and with that said, thanks for watching and I wish you happy automating.